One Championship showcases Asia's biggest cultural treasure and celebrates the beauty and values of martial arts globally. In the pursuit of excellence, real-life heroes of the sport motivate, captivate, and inspire. You're watching the Best of One Championship. With world-class grapplers in ONE Championship's roster, 2018 included some incredible submission victories, like the bout that put ONE strawweight world champion Joshua Pacio into world title contention. He faced Thailand's Pong Sari Mitsateet, utilizing a beautiful submission that Pacio called the Passion Lock.
A strawweight bout, Joshua Pacio of the Philippines, Pong Sari Mitsateet of Thailand. And this one brought to you by City of Dreams, Manila. More power to your play.
Two very accomplished strikers. We might see the Go Daddy knockout of the night here, Michael.
We may indeed. Both men predict finishes. Pacio says triangle submission. Pong Sari Mitsateet says KO overhand right. And the power Mitsateet packs in that right hand is ungodly. Looks for the inside leg to Pacio. Mitsateet looks like he's leaned up a little for this one, Mitch.
Yeah, he spent a lot of time out there at Tiger Muay Thai getting ready for this matchup. And he says that he incorporated a little bit more strength and conditioning than usual into his program. We got the Muay Thai style of Mitsateet going against that Filipino Wushu style of Joshua Pacio. Contrast of style should make for entertaining action, though.
Clinch up for the first time. Pacio, big takedown, side control.
Beautiful change of directions. Right as he got that leg, Mitsateet was defending one way and Pacio took him the other.
The final match of our prelims, just glancing around this massive arena, and we're about 90% full.
Look how heavy Pacio is. You can see Mitsateet had the underhook and he tried to hit bump. But Pacio remained heavy and was able to transition into mount. This is where those submission skills are going to come in real handy for Pacio. Full mount, has the legs grapevine, soften him up.
This place will be jam-packed in about 20 minutes, half an hour's time. And they are watching Joshua Pacio in control. Full mount on Pong Sari Mitsateet in the opening round. There's the right hand from Pacio. Already one win on the board tonight for Team Philippines, courtesy of Rene Catalan with an upset over Stepa Rahardian. Drops the elbows now, does Pacio. Here comes the Filipino power, rakes the elbow again.
Setting up an arm triangle. Let's see if he transitions over into the other side, but
he predicted submission by triangle, Mitch. Can it be prophetic here for Pacio?
And see, he's trying to get that arm underneath. This is what he's been working on. Mitsateet's got to just kind of, you know, ignore the posturing and put his hands on the hips and elevate Pacio.
It's the ground and pound from Pacio. Mitsateet in trouble. The elbows. Look at him posture up again. This place going crazy. It's deafening for Pacio.
Mitsateet's trying to scramble. This might be enough, but oh, Pacio takes the back, looking for that rear naked choke.
Pacio looking to send Manila into a meltdown in the last match of our prelims.
Take a look at the right, see that left hand of Pacio is underneath it, cradling that arm there, so he can use the right hand to try to get underneath the chin. It's close. Might be a little bit too high. He needs to settle down a little bit lower.
Mitsateet is undefeated, 9-0. He may be staring down the barrel of his first ever loss.
Oh, look what Joshua Pacio, look at what he did to the arm.
He is. Pacio taps him out. Manila in a meltdown.
Michael, we got to take another look at that submission. He was in the back position. And he had it, he had his left hand controlling the left hand of Mitsateet. He came across with his right hand and pulled that left hand of Mitsuti up into a rear naked chicken wing. What was that? That was beautifully done. What creativity from Joshua Pacio.
Mitch Chilson making up moves. A rear naked chicken wing is what the Dragon has dubbed it here. Here it is, Mitch.
Take a look at this. Oh, it's not doing, the angle is not doing it justice. Look at this, how he has the arm and then he cranks it completely back.
I'll pay it, Mitch, rear naked chicken wing. You've dubbed it. You've dubbed it.
Maybe we could call it a reverse Kimura. I don't know what that was, but look at that. His arm, his hand almost touched the back of his head.
And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 37 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of arm lock, Joshua Pacio.
What an ovation for 22-year-old Joshua Pacio. The biggest win of Pacio's career, stopping the streak of Pongsuri Mitsutit and doing so in a highlight reel fashion.
Japanese grappling legend Shinya Aoki had an incredible year, beginning with his victory over the Russian Rasul Yakayev.
This one set for three rounds. Inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium, where they've turned out by their thousands for one championship, Unstoppable Dreams. Shinya Aoki, former world champion, bounds out of his corner.
Shinya's looking to close the distance, slide under the punches, just like that.
Yakayev almost caught him coming in with that tagging right hand, puts Aoki against the cage. Peppering rights there from the Russian.
Good job for Yakayev to spin him around. Has a deep underhook on the left side. But Shinya Aoki flies into an armbar, into an omoplata.
Not where Yakayev wants to be. You don't want Aoki on top of you. Not this early anyway.
We were talking about the creativity, and that is a perfect example of it. Beautiful. He's known for his flying triangles. He's known for his flying armbars. And that was a beautiful transition from an armbar into an omoplata. Now Shinya's on top, creating a lot of heavy top pressure.
One of the finest BJJ exponents in the sport, Shinya Aoki, top position on Rasul Yakayev. Where does Yakayev go from here, Dragon?
Well, first he's got to create a little bit of space. So he's got to try to get that left arm underneath Shinya Aoki's right arm to carry a bit of an underhook. He's trying to frame off the face to do that, to create a little bit of space so he can get that in there. Hard time, but a deep, look at that. Just look at the pressure. I know the squeeze. I have been on the bottom with Shinya Aoki. He is so strong. His hands look like a bunch of bananas. They're so big, and he's got so much top pressure.
Still top position here for Shinya Aoki. We are joined by world's heavyweight champion, The Truth, Brandon Vera. Brandon, great to be here. What a night in Singapore.
This is an amazing time. I've never been to the stadium here, indoor arena, and this crowd is live. The fights are amazing. God, thank you for having me.
It's great to have you here, champ. And we're seeing Shinya Aoki, Mitch, in control of Rasul Yakayev.
Shinya seems very comfortable just to stay here in half guard. He's not trying to pass. You can see the sort of the position that Yakayev has, almost a lockdown position where he has the legs threaded under, but Shinya's trying, now he's trying to pass. He's trying to slide the knee up, trying to get through. Yakayev made his debut in one championship and looked real good against Shannon Wierichai, put on a very impressive game plan. So I hope that transitions here and he can figure out a way to get out of this heavy top pressure from Shinya Aoki.
Brandon, if you're in the corner of Yakayev, what are you telling the Russian to do here off his back?
He needs to get that pressure off of his chest, get his back up on the fence, wall walk, and get up so he's not underneath Shinya. This is the worst position for him to be in.
Aoki looking to take home those in an omoplata there, Mitch.
Beautiful transition into a triangle. Got the mount from the triangle position, has it deep, but Yakayev's trying to punch his way out of it. But as he's doing that, Shinya's adjusting. He's taking the punches to get that triangle even tighter.
I thought we may have seen a more passive Aoki tonight, but he has brought the grappling aggression early on here. Look at this triangle. Yakayev in all sorts of bother.
Armbar on the right side, Michael.
Oh, it's good night, Irene! Aoki's back in the winner's circle, as Aoki does, tapping opponents out.
That was a double threat right there. Had the triangle, got it tighter and tighter as Yakiyaev was trying to punch his way out, but then caught him in a straight arm lock and got the armbar finish. That is impressive. That is classic Aoki. Two submissions in one.
Brandon Vera, we've seen two guys back-to-back who want to crack at the lightweight championship again. Edward for lying, and now Shinya Aoki. That was classic.
That would be a beautiful matchup. The classic striker versus the ground guy. This submission, like you said, the two-for-one package that he gave him was perfect. You couldn't ask for anybody to be more calm, collected, and cool in there during the match.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 15 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of triangle choke, Shinya Aoki!
Shinya Aoki brings the house down in Singapore. Another submission of the highest order from a man who can do them the very best, and he can do them all.
Leandro Issa faced Roman Alvarez, and the bout featured back-and-forth Brazilian jiu-jitsu action.
It should be an absolute cracker as Roman Alvarez takes on Brodinho Leandro Issa in front of a sellout crowd in Yangon, Myanmar. Fake early there from Alvarez, wild overhand right. Brodinho did say he's got to watch out for the wild looping punches of the man from Guam. Jab from Issa. Oh, the left hook drops him, and another one! Here comes the boom! Here comes the boom! Two left hands from Roman Alvarez. And Brodinho recovers, looks for a takedown, but what an explosive start!
What a punch landed by Alvarez. But this is Brodinho's world. Look for Brodinho to try to control, settle back down, regain his wits, and then start to drop a little bit of ground and kind of pass that guard.
What a start on one championship debut for the boom, Roman Alvarez. And this is not where he wants to be, with Leandro Issa on top of him inside of half guard. The Brazilian with all sorts of options from him.
Wow, Alvarez came out huge with some big shots landed, but now Brodinho is able to get his wits about him. A little bit too gung-ho as he entered into the takedown there as he tried to jump on Brodinho because he was hurt. Easy pass from Brodinho. Now he's got an arm triangle on that one side, and to escape it, Alvarez might give up his back, and oh, he's gonna take the arm triangle.
Oh, he's turning, this one could be over. It's good night, Irene! Brodinho puts Roman Alvarez to sleep.
Wow, Brodinho able to recover from adversity. Alvarez landed a big shot as Brodinho stumbled back, but Alvarez went in for the kill, and then Brodinho was able to control, regain his composure, and then once he got on top, that was all she wrote. Slid over beautifully into mount, locked on that arm triangle. Alvarez tried to fight it off, but Brodinho able to capture another submission win.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 26 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of arm triangle choke, Leandro Issa!
Leandro Issa, phenomenal sportsmanship from a phenomenal athlete. The winner's medal around the neck of the man they call Brodinho, doing what he does best, tapping.
When we return, we've got more top martial arts action with ONE Championship's finest submissions of 2018. You're watching the best of ONE Championship. Welcome back. You're watching the best of ONE Championship, and we're celebrating the most outstanding submissions of 2018. Another spectacular submission occurred in the bout between Robin Catalan and Adrian Matez. We join the action in the second round.
Robin Catalan against Adrian Matez, who needs a big second stanza here.
So you can see Catalan just kind of backing up a little bit, throwing those kicks, expect him to go to the inside leg with that lead leg of his. But he's trying to bait Matias into it, you know, because he knows just how aggressive Matias is. And he just does it just like that, catches the leg kick as he tries to suck in the legs of Matias.
Matias glances towards his corner. Catalan wants him on his back, gets him there. Half guard position for Robin Catalan. Not where Matias wanted to be so early in the round, but Catalan did tell us yesterday the wrestling and the takedown defense are the weaknesses of Adrian Matias, and he's exploited that so far, Mitch.
Yeah, we've seen pretty much all the Filipino athletes really just excel in the grappling department. You know, for a long time, they were just one-dimensional strikers, but you can see just how much mixed martial arts has evolved in the Philippines with, you know, members of Team Lakai showing superior ground techniques, and the Catalans are really putting together some high-level grappling.
Popping left hand from inside the closed guard there from Robin Catalan. What are the options for Adrian Matias from here, Mitch?
Well, he's got an active guard. He's trying to move through the guard, and he's trying to hand control right there from, you know, Catalan. So he's trying to grip the wrist, but he's not really trying to advance his position. He's not trying to sweep. He's not really threatening any submissions. So his really only option is to put his feet on the hips, push away, and stand back up.
Catalan staying right on top of him here, working from inside the guard. Good right hand to the jaw there from Catalan, then drops the elbow across the orbital. Chambers the right, couldn't get it off. What's he looking for here, Mitch?
Oh, Catalan's going after a leg again. Looks like he's possibly got a heel hook.
Yep. And he has indeed. Beautiful submission in the second round for Robin Catalan, and he is elated as Adrian Matias clutches at his left knee.
You could see him at the end of the first round, Catalan chased after that heel, and then, oh, he sticks the landing on the backflip, and then he dove down again, went after the heel hook, and had a beautiful submission there. And look at Robin Catalan getting a submission win via heel hook.
Prediction comes true for Robert Catalan. Great sportsmanship, great martial arts spirit shown between these two athletes, and here's how it went down.
Check this out, right there. He laced the leg, locked his right leg over the hip right there. He's nice and high, has the heel caught in the lock, and then just slowly started to extend the hips to place all that pressure on the knee. And you could see Adrian Matias grimacing as Catalan captures a big win.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 10 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of heel hook, Robin Catalan!
That is certainly a career highlight victory for Robin Catalan. And prophetically, he told us yesterday, I'm going to get him on the ground. I'm going to submit him. It came true for Catalan tonight.
Martial arts legend faced martial arts legend as sixth-degree Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt Renzo Gracie took on Japanese veteran Yuki Kondo in a bout for the ages. We join the action in the second round.
Second round, Kondo goes back to the inside leg. Can Gracie find an opportunity to take Yuki Kondo down? They are barking instructions in the corner of Yuki Kondo, screaming at him like Gordon Ramsay.
That's what Kondo needs to do, back him up and throw some big shots. Put some combinations together. Throw the straight right, big straight left, big right hook.
Renzo's talking to Yuki Kondo. He's trying to bait him in here. And again, Renzo having words, calling Yuki forward, throws a right hand against the southpaw. And Kondo probing with the jab. Kondo's chin a little high now. Enzo saw the opening, went with the right hand again.
I'd like to see him double up on that shot.
Left hook, right hand, 3-2, and a single leg here from Enzo. Can he get a takedown? Takes the back standing.
He gets the back. Look how he laced in the leg. Look at that control on the back.
And this is where Gracie wants to be.
Oh, he shoots that arm in, looking for the rear naked.
This is Enzo's territory. This is Enzo's world. He glances towards his corner.
What if Enzo finishes with the passion lock?
How about this? How about this?
Oh, there's a rear naked choke. It's in.
How about this? Go on, man. Go on, man. It's gone. Nice, Irene. Enzo Gracie's back. Enzo Gracie's back. In pure Enzo style, he taps out Kondo in the second round.
A bit of a slow first round, but once Enzo knew what he wanted to do, he went right after it. Got the single leg, dragged him to the mat, jumped on the back, stuck in the rear naked choke, and that is all she wrote.
51 years old. Unscathed and victorious, Enzo Gracie's comeback, a success in Manila. He scales the cage and gets an ovation from the sellout crowd. Enzo Gracie upped the aggressor meter in the second round. And look at this, puts the hooks in, sinks the rear naked choke, and Kondo forced to tap out before he goes to sleep.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 40 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Enzo Gracie!
Enzo Gracie completes a fairy tale comeback after a 7-year absence. A superb submission, a superb takedown. Enzo Gracie victorious in Manila.
Ariel Sexton faced Kota Shimoishi and pulled off one of the most creative submissions of the year. We join the action in the third round.
This has been an electrifying way to kick off one championship pursuit of power. It's Ariel Sexton and Kota Shimoishi, one round to go. Both men have had their chances. And look at the stalking stance. Shimoishi, who was so successful with the takedowns in the second round.
Oh, Ariel Sexton reached down to snatch that Kimura, letting those hands go. He's doing so well in the stand-up. Why is he trying to clinch? Maybe this is why. Maybe because he sees something in the ground and pound.
Big right hand missed the target. Sexton takes the back now of Shimoishi. Oh, look at this! Look at this! Shimoishi in trouble! He's all tied up like a pretzel, and it's good! Night! Freaking Irene! That was amazing! What was that?
That was a reverse triangle with an Americana. That one is, that's his signature move. He called it.
Unbelievable.
Did you see the way he stepped over as Shimoishi was trying to tangle? He steps over. He was kind of looking for that the entire time. Look at that. Americana, reverse triangle. Oh, no place to go. What a world of hurt.
That's two submissions for the price of one.
Look at this finish. Has a beautiful reverse triangle, and then look at that, cranks on the key lock to get the tap.
That is the finest submission we have seen this year.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has put a stop to this contest after 44 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of Americana, Ariel Sexton!
Tarzan with the most amazing submission you'll see. Ariel Sexton with the winner's medal. The Costa Rican flag flying high in Malaysia.
When we return, we continue our look at ONE Championship's most outstanding submissions of 2018. You're watching the best of ONE Championship. Welcome back. You're watching the best of ONE Championship, and we're celebrating the most phenomenal submissions of 2018. Continuing his reign of 2018, Shinya Aoki took on Malaysian Ev Ting in an outstanding and dominating performance.
This one will determine the number one contender spot in the lightweight division.
Judge time. Ready? Ready? Choke!
Will it be the old school, nasty, mean Shinya Aoki? How will he handle the striking of the human highlight reel, Ev Ting?
Interesting choice of opening moves for Ev Ting to attempt that high kick that's going to allow Shinya to get in tight. Oh no, he's immediately got it to the ground. He's passing into side control. Ev Ting does a good job to get back into half guard, but watch Aoki step over. Check out that left leg.
In the opening seconds of this mixed martial arts contest, Ev Ting on his back, Aoki on top.
Ev Ting's got a hold of that head, but he's got to let go of that head and start pushing away. Shinya Aoki, he's actually helping Aoki. You don't want to get, you want to create space when you're defending, you know? And by holding the head like this, he's keeping Aoki tight to him. And there's also a choke right here. Here comes the arm triangle.
Is it going to be an early finish? Is it? Shinya Aoki, the number one contender for the lightweight championship.
Wow, Shinya Aoki got the choke. He did exactly what I said he was going to do. He wanted to avoid the damage, close the distance. Look at him traveling deep into the upper decks to celebrate with his fans. I think he's forgot that he needs to get back down here.
This is what Aoki did last time. He scaled the stands, went to the upper rafters, and he's done it again. He put the lights out literally on Ev Ting as Ev Ting went to sleep.
He jumped from the top of the rafters down. That's like a 15-foot drop right there, Michael.
Amazing scenes inside the Impact Arena. That's the Shinya Aoki of old. The relentless mean streak is back. Now the number one contender. Of course, the lightweight title will be decided November 23 in Manila between Edward Folayang and Emir Khan, and the winner will face Shinya Aoki. My word, that was awesome.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 57 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of arm triangle, Shinya Aoki!
Shinya Aoki, what planet do you come from? 26 submissions now in 42 wins. Three first-round finishes in a row over Shannon Wirichai, Russell Yakyaye, and now Ev Ting.
Former ONE Featherweight World Champion Murat Gafarov reminded the world why he's a man to be afraid of on the ground when he put on a tremendous show against Emilio Urrutia.
Judge.
The death stare of Murat Gafarov.
Ready?
The intensity
Ready?
Of the honey
Ready?
Badger,
go!
Emilio Urrutia. He could make coffee nervous. Here we go, first round set for three.
Look for Urrutia to utilize that jab and then go after that low leg kick. He likes to attack the lower portion of the leg. And you can see a little bit of I think it's road rash that he got in Thailand from Gafarov there on that left leg. So look for that to be a target of Urrutia. Oh, immediately, but Gafarov saw it coming, catches the low kick, and takes Urrutia down.
No chance for the striking for Emilio Urrutia. Inside the guard is Gafarov, and Urrutia locks down that left arm. Gafarov trying to pass to the left side of the body.
Easily pushes down that leg to pass in the half. Now he's trying to step over the right leg of Urrutia to get into full mount.
Center.
Gafurov told us in his six-week camp he worked on his wrestling, on his ground control, and his head movement. Said, all I need to watch out for tonight is a lucky punch from Emilio, nothing else. Gafurov predicting he'll sit Urrutia. Says, I want to prove to the world my loss to Martin Ewan was bad luck, as he calls it. He says, I'm still number one in the featherweight division. He's got to prove tonight that he is deserving of another title shot. 1 foot on hips here from Urrutia, and Gafurov takes that off, so Urrutia closes guard.
Give him the close guard, keeping him nice and tight. Look for him to try to get a butterfly hook where he takes his foot and actually tries to put it on the thigh, but he's going up high to a possible triangle, maybe looking for an arm bar as well. But Arutia's got a heavy top game, but he's good off his back. I've been on the mat with Urrutia, and I know how strong he is down there. But I can only imagine how powerful Gafurov is.
Gafurov, an absolute martial arts monster, goes to the body, then the head of Urrutia. Urrutia controlling the Russian's posture. What should Emilio be looking to do here, Mitch?
Well, you probably think that he probably either wants to walk his guard up nice and high where his legs are a little bit higher up on the torso of Gafurov, or start, now he's got half guard, so now it's a different position. Now he's gonna look, try to get an underhook on the same side that Gafurov is. You can see that Gafurov's trying to right now lock in an arm triangle. So Emilio's got to be careful. He's got to be careful because you can see Gafurov's working his way around. Now it's in.
Oh, Gafurov is turning. Oh. He's turning counterclockwise. This is trouble.
Urrutia's got to defend. He's got to keep the arm there. He might go to sleep.
Oh, he looks at moisture. Seals in freshness. Good night, Irene. The Cobra's back. The Cobra's back. The Cobra is back.
You can see him limping. That calf kick did some damage. But once he got on top, it was a step-by-step process that was almost academic. Gafurov was in top control. He passed. He got into from the half guard. He got in, once he got past side control, he was able to stick that arm up. Urrutia was defending correctly, but I can only imagine the squeeze that Gafurov's got where he actually, no tap necessary. Emilio Urrutia went out with his on his shield and got put to sleep.
Mitch, what message has Marat Gafurov just sent to both Christian Lee and Martin Ewing?
I am next.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 34 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of arm triangle, Marat Gafurov!
Marat Gafurov back at the winner's circle. And the Cobra doing what the Cobra does best. He needs to change his name really to the Anaconda because he chokes people out.
When we return, more action in the One Championship cage. You're watching the Best of One Championship. Welcome back to the Best of One Championship. Reese McLaren faced Gianni Suba in an epic clash.
The atmosphere here inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Is electric.
Just time. Ready?
Reese McLaren Ready? Of Australia. Gianni Suba of Malaysia. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Early fakes and feints here from Suba in the white. Can one of these two men score the big kibosh, the go daddy knockout of the night? You figure it may come from Suba. He's the knockout master. On the ground, Reese McLaren should, on paper, have the advantage. Inside leg kick from Suba. McLaren, southpaw starts, left-handed. Thought about a high kick, did the Aussie. Suba fakes again. Both men have speed in the hands, speed in the legs. Looks for a takedown as McLaren, Suba stuffs it.
Ooh, good confidence builder from Suba, stops that initial takedown. He's got McLaren up against the cage.
No fence, no fence, no fence.
Fence. clearings him around against the cage here, Mitch.
Controls the clinch, has the body lock. Look at that, nice and tight from both guys. Look at him struggle.
Going reversal upon reversal. Both men pressing their backs against the cage.
Fence.
The pendulum swinging one way, then the other. This is what you call jousting.
Looking for McLaren to change levels. But Subi's got that underhook on that one side, on that right side, so it's going to be hard for McLaren to drop down. Going inside knee tap.
Let's go, guys. Hook.
Trying to change.
Elbow there from Johnny Suba off the right arm. McLaren would love to get Suba down. Love to put Suba on his back. So many options for lightning Reese from there. Suba would like to break off, have some distance to work his striking. Those knockout blows off his hands. McLaren keeps him pressed back against the cage, Mitch.
This first exchange is going to tell us a lot. Is McLaren going to be able to win the battle of attrition, drop down, change levels, get the takedown? Or is Suba going to ignite this crowd, survive this position, and get away?
Left
and he does just that.
Left hook at the breakup from Suba. And there's the right hand, the power shoulder. Jab two from McLaren. Now McLaren in orthodox stance. Body shot from Suba, trying to change angles, trying to disguise his punches.
Trying to move an ankle pick there. Suba fell for it a bit. Let's see if he uses that later somehow in the round.
McLaren with the jab. Switches back to southpaw. Constantly switching stance here is the Australian. Suba swings a little wilder off the backhand. There's a ripping high right roundhouse kick. Loses his footing there as McLaren.
Saw the striking on display when McLaren went five rounds with the champion in a higher weight division, Bibiano Fernandez, one of the world's best. We saw McLaren break Bibiano's nose, completely deform his face.
Suba trying to give McLaren a taste of the power in his gloves. There's a right hand from the Malaysian. Cracking roundhouse kick, but Suba saw it coming, managed to scoop it away. Drops the right hand to the bread basket.
That's just Suba being a little bit tentative on the strikes, not really hasn't really opened up yet. He rushes there and connects with the right hand.
Good straight line punches down the center corridor from Suba. And McLaren will have no more of it. Driving takedown, look for a choke attempt. Ooh. And now the full mount from the Aussie.
Just jumps right into full mount.
Oh, downward elbows, top of the head. McLaren getting higher on the mount. This is McLaren's territory.
Suba wants to push off the leg, start moving those hips out, not trying to sit up like that. Now McLaren's got him up against the cage.
McLaren with the elbows. His corner's telling him to stay heavy on top of Suba. This is where McLaren wanted to be. The elbows again from the Aussie.
See how Reese laces around the left hand? Hits that left hand of Suba so he can't defend. He can't start pushing off of it. Good defense, good offensive strategy by McLaren. Now he's trying to frame up on it. Now he's going to try to jump over into half guard.
Goes to side control.
Right to side control. Now he's attacking the head.
Dominance on the ground here from Lightning Reese McLaren.
He's trying to walk over north-south. There's a choke here. He's got a hidden arm.
Time may be against McLaren. It is indeed. End of the first round. Second round of three.
Ready?
Choke! McLaren bounds out of his corner. He switched between southpaw and orthodox in the opening round. And he opens up a southpaw here in the second.
Suba's got to be careful rushing in like that. That's what Jason McLaren's going to do for that takedown.
Lovely counter right hand there from Suba.
Ate the body kick to counter with a right hand of his own.
Oh, beautiful, almost taekwondo. Jumping roundhouse kick there from Suba. Both men do a little posturing, a little posing. The crowd enjoys it. Two highly skilled martial arts athletes at the peak of their powers, Mitch.
Just big whiff on that kick. Both of them calling their shots, pointing to the upper deck.
Jab from Suba.
Now we're starting to see the swagger start to ooze out of McLaren. This is what we saw in the Bibiano fight. If he wasn't doing so much posturing, if he wasn't doing so much showboating, I think he could have caught, he might be holding the bantamweight belt right now. I don't want to see him get caught up too much in this and have too much fun in there. I want to see him start to put it on in Tsuba, because Tsuba ain't falling for it.
It's a little something gold, the Aussie Larrikin Nightjet. And it's coming out again here in Reese McLaren.
American?
American Nightjet. A rascal, a larrikin. That's what Reese McLaren is. But it's also a way for McLaren to try and get inside of Suba's head. Suba comes forward with track line punches. Goes for the inside leg. McLaren hasn't switched to orthodox. He's maintained the southpaw stance. Tries for a takedown, uppercut, hook combination from McLaren. He had his left hand, didn't turn the knuckles in.
Like I said, he's going after the lower leg. He's going after that calf and shin of McLaren, which is going to slow down that shot. I'd like to see him keep doing it. Throw those punches, throw that low kick.
Overhand right there from McLaren. Suba jab, sprawls out nicely. Good takedown defense from the Malaysian. Eats a left hand to the jaw. Looks for the hamstring there. Does McLaren.
Goes for a knee tap there.
High knee!
Misses.
Trying for the meet and greet. The Muay Thai technique from Reese McLaren. Suba locks him up. McLaren breaks out. Suba comes forward. A little sloppy on execution of those two straight punches. Look at the feet here on both these men, the way they stand. You'll see McLaren's back foot is very, very solid out, much more so than Johnny Suba's.
He's having a hard time moving back. He takes about two steps forward, and that's where Suba's connecting him.
McLaren hoped for a takedown. Gets a takedown. Suba on his back. McLaren's getting melted again.
Falls
now passes
mouth
to side control. Here's the choke.
Arm triangle.
Here's
deep.
The choke.
Done, Michael. Dove into the double leg. Let's take a look at that one more time. That was so pretty. He dove into the double leg, slides over, gets the arm triangle, and just puts the squeeze on. There's the Lee family.
Angela Lee, Bruno Pucci, Christian Lee. Angela will be taking on Mai Yamaguchi in a rematch in May in Singapore. But here's what went down in this incredible finish.
Look at that double leg. Got the knee tap, fell into the top position, got the mount right into the arm triangle. And that's how big, how strong of a squeeze that McLaren's got. Suba, no place to go. Taps Reese McLaren into a world title shot.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 12 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of arm triangle, Reese McLaren.
A beautiful round of applause from this Malaysian crowd for Reese McLaren. They appreciate great martial arts here in Malaysia. And they appreciate a great martial artist like Lightning, Reese McLaren.
Grappling superstar Gary Tonin continued his undefeated streak in an impressive performance against Sung Jong Lee. We join the action in the second round.
You ever get the chance to talk to Gary Tonin, and I tell you what, he is an enlightened man on so many subjects, and he'll talk to you for hours. A real gentleman as well. Second round of three. Now, once again, both men said it would not go past two rounds. This is the round that Sung Jong Lee said he would knock out Gary Tonin in.
Sung Jong Lee's got to put that jab out there. He's got, as Gary Tonin's closing the distance, Sung Jong Lee's got to utilize the jab. Gary Tonin is usually like throwing way too many jabs.
Counter right hand there from Sung Jong Lee. The head movement again from Tonin. The boxing has improved out of sight, particularly the jab of Tonin. high up again on the balls of his feet, working the kicking arsenal now. There's a front kick to the midsection from the American. Dances back to center cage. Outside leg kick, inside leg kick. A striking display here, 101 from Gary Tonin.
This is a very different striker from the second time that we saw him.
You know what, Mitch? We're seeing the kicks here from Tonin, but Sung Jong Lee began his martial arts career in the National Korean Art of Taekwondo, an art renowned for its kicking arsenal.
And he hasn't thrown a kick yet.
Nope. 2016 Naganogi Grappling Championship at under 160 pounds. Sung Jong Lee, purple belt in BJJ, loves the heel hook. Imagine slapping a heel hook on Gary Tonin. Don't think it'll happen. But let's see if he can swing for a knockout here in the second round. Gary Tonin, look at the movements on Tonin. Circles off clockwise, now drifts to his right. Full of confidence oozing out of every pore here for Gary Tonin. The jab, oh, look at the evasion and the takedown. That was sweet, that was slick.
That was beautiful, he slid out of the way. Oh, nice little butterfly sweep there, but he's giving up a guillotine.
Oh, this is trouble!
You don't want to give your neck to Gary Tonin. He's going to keep adjusting until he finds it. But Sung Jong Lee did a good job there of swinging over into half guard. Got into side control, but look at Gary Tonin. He adjusted it in. Oh, that's nasty.
Oh, hold on. Wait a minute. Let me put some Tonin in it. Gary Tonin does it again. He is 3-0, and he is looking simply superb.
Sung Jong Lee gave him too many opportunities with that choke. He got it once. Sung Jong Lee did a good job of moving around, trying to fight it off. But Gary Tonin got it twice, didn't quite have it. Third time, look at these adjustments. This is world-class grappling on display right here. He's like, nope, don't quite have it here. Let me make this minor adjustment. You come into over into me, I'm gonna let you come into me, and then I'm gonna take you on top, mount you, and then I'm gonna finish you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 4 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine, Gary Tonin!
3-0, a 100% finishing rate, competing at featherweight tonight, and he looked absolutely superb. A flawless performance from Gary Tonin. Can you imagine where he'll be in 12 months' time?
One Championship continues to celebrate Asia's biggest cultural treasures and the beauty and values of martial arts. The exciting action of 2018 inspired the world. Keep an eye out in 2019 for more martial arts inspiration. One Championship is the home of martial arts. Thank you for watching the Best of One Championship.